It's rowdy here in Fist Energy Stadium. Even though the economy is a mess in this city, these are some of the best sports fans in the country.
I heard things were so bad that Leaveland Casino was turned into an Indian reservation, Grim. Yeah, why don't you just open a window and take a leak all over the fans?
The teams are juiced up and ready for blood as they take the field for MFL action. The Midway Mutants battle the Leaveland Burns. Welcome to MFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say. If you like your cocktail cold, your soup hot, and your steak still mooing, then you're gonna love seeing mutants knocked cold, their brains turned into hot lava soup, and their bodies strewn about the field, lying still and barely moving. MFL Game Day is on the air.
Aw, you just made me hungry, Grim. I'm gonna go get some extra crispy mutant finger strips.
Hey, get me a full slab of broken mutant ribs while you're there.
And it's first and 10. Like he just ran into the line at the DMV.
And guess what, Grim? That line ain't moving.
Yeah, that was kind of my point, Bricks.
Second down and 10. He picks up 9 yards on that catch. And that'll bring up third and 1. He was stuffed at the line of scrimmage.
So was that cheerleader.
Thank God he's still got his leg. He's going to need all of it for this kick.
Hey, a sawbuck says he misses.
It's good. The teams are lined up for the kickoff. He's going to be able to run this one back.
I wonder if the kicker was setting up an easy kill.
And it's first and 10. The way to get the sticks moving. He picks up 5 yards on that play. Second down and 5.
Yeah, ain't nothing worse than wasting a good explosive.
Third down and 5. And the ball razors through the defense, cutting a defender in half.
But that means he can wrap up the other half and save it for...
He could go all the way. The 20. He's at the 10. Someone better buy this guy dinner tonight because he just saved a touchdown with that tackle. First and 2. Don't try to get fancy here. Just put the ball down and kick it.
In that order, Grim?
It goes right through.
Yeah, like a
When you get knocked down, you gotta get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
And it's first and ten. Punishing hit that was. And that's how you make a guy remember your name and your shoe size. Because he just walked all over him. Second down and nine. He was starting to go somewhere, but he gets stumped after three.
They usually stop me after three, too. You know, the all-you-can-eat buffets? They're not as literal as you think.
Third down and six. First and ten. And he sticks his fingers in the defender's eyes, netting him a pickup of about eight on the play. Second down and two. Pick up the first down with a nice piece of running there. And it's first and ten. First down! He was not going to drop that one. They need to make him a target more often. And it's first and ten. Perfect pass and a score!
Hey, man, you see that? That's right, you can't handle this. You can't handle what I got. Yeah, get the hell out of here, man.
Now, there are some who would argue that we should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth seven.
What, and kick the kicker's job in half? They'd just be called sitters then.
It's good. The home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five. And it's first and ten. Oh, and he looks like he just saw 400 scary movies after that hit.
Yeah, sounds like my off season.
Second and three. What the hell was that?
I honestly don't know, Grim.
It's anyone's game still at this point.
I know, which makes it so hard to place a bet.
And it's first and ten. Quarterback threads the needle for a first down. And it's first and ten. And he laterals the ball. Man, these guys like playing. And that's how you run the football. First down. First and eight to go. They call it a warp speed dirty trick. The defense was there, but he still picked up a yard somehow. Second down and 7. And he put on the afterburners after that catch and scored. And if you don't understand why refs are hated even more than kickers, well, there's your answer, Frick.
I know, I hate those zebra men.
Second down, and they've had enough. The offense jumps off sides and attacks the ref. Second down and a mile. Third down and 6. And he laterals at the line. And he runs into the end zone for a touchdown. And they line up for the extra point. Right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make him pay. It's 1st and 10. Second down and long. Oh, the defense must have called a hot potato dirty trick. That'll wake you up and then put you to sleep permanently.
You snooze, you lose!
Unless you're in a sleeping contest.
Third down and the punter is warming up. Well, fee-fi-fo-fum!
I'm not finishing that joke, Grim. The only low-hanging fruit is on the...
Oh, a great catch, and he picks up a new set of downs! And it's 1st and 10. Quarterback calls a sonic blast, and the quarterback drills one in for the first down. First down and 6. And the crowd goes wild. Touchdown! Touchdown! Yeah, this should be an easy chip shot extra point, but you never know with kickers. Straight through the uprights. The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
It's first and ten.
You ever get hit in the head with a boat all grim?
Nope.
Well, I have on several occasions.
Not surprising.
Multiple times on each occasion.
Not surprising.
And trust me, that hit was worse.
Whenever a player gets big like this, reminds me of that Tom Hanks movie.
Ah, Philadelphia, good movie.
Yeah, Philadelphia, Bricks. Keep drinking the cough syrup. Third down and, well, good luck. Oh, he just heard footsteps and took his eye off the ball.
What a peck ahead. Catch the ball, asshole. Hey, asshole up here. Talking to you.
And the defense anticipated a pass there and put an end to their. At some point, they're going to need to put this ref out of his misery.
How about now, for instance? Here's a hint. Dirty tricks, attack the ref.
And it's first and ten. And the offense jumps off sides to kill the ref. They say, we're mad as hell and not going to take it anymore. First down and forever. And there's a huge gain, and this offense is rolling.
Marvin, that was a pass play. Rolling plays are in bowling.
Second down and a very lot. Crusher right there, folks. And he takes a timeout here. They have two left. I wonder if he has a plan.
He's just gonna take the teeth out of the back of his neck that have been stuck there since the opening play.
And the quarterback finds his man for the first down. And the offense quickly calls their second timeout. That's how you do it.
Do what?
And it's first and ten. And the defense gets the quarterback for a sack. Timeout. The clock just became their greatest enemy.
Really? The clock? The clock, Grim? I can smash a clock. That's not a great enemy.
We're not talking about waking up at the crack of noon. We're talking about the MFL, you moron.
That's a nice gain of about 7 yards on that run. Third down, and the punter is warming up. Catches it for a touchdown! What a beautiful play!
Yeah, it's almost poetic, Ring, like a haiku!
Hey, man, nobody can touch me when I ball. I take all you mutants out. That's right. Hey, what you talking about, pal?
You know, this shouldn't be easy, but with kickers, you never know. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the kicker. When I turned on the light, it wasn't a broad in my bed. It was a chick wearing a wig.
First and ten. Pow! With the brain scrambler! try and stay in this game.
Oh, nice coaching move there. Hall of Fame caliber.
Well, I mean, it's a pretty standard coaching move at this point in the game.
I won't listen to this blasphemy.
And then it's a first down from a great catch.
Was it a catch, though? Let's consult.
They used their second timeout, but they are running out of time.
A bit pessimistic, don't you think so, Grim?
It's more about building tension, Bricks. That's all we do at this point. And drink this bourbon. Come on, give me that.
Oh, sure, now he catches it. I had this guy on my fantasy team last week. I lost so much.
And they take their last timeout.
It's between them and the clock now, Grim.
Well, and the defense, too. Now, this one's going to be tough. I hope he has a good enough leg for this one.
I saw him trying one on before the game. He looked okay, I think. Not my type, though. A little too...
Well, surprise me. He made it look easy, and he gets 3 points for it. They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
Gonna hurt. He may not be able to comprehend math after that hit.
What?
The second quarter comes to a close as the teams head for the locker room, and we take you to halftime. Brought to you by Monsanto Industries. We make genetically engineered food that is to die for. It's the start of the third quarter, and we are set to go, Bricks.
Oh boy, where we going, Grim? A carnival? I'm gonna go to a striptease show. Where we going?
Yeah, why don't you settle down? Just pet your rabbit, Lenny. Just pet your rabbit. Let's see if they can keep the momentum going and keep these fans happy and or bloodthirsty, whichever. Oh, that was a vicious hit. There might not be an eye in team, but this guy's eyeballs are all over the other team's helmets right now. And it's first and ten. Catch the ball, get the first down, and don't die. See, it's really a simple game when it comes down to it. And it's first and ten.
If that hit didn't cripple him, it certainly left skid marks.
And that'll be second down and four. Maybe the QB should throw it and catch it, too. Third and four. And he sends him to the ground with an exclamation point.
And a well-placed cleat.
And it's first and ten. He picks up a two. And that'll be second and eight to go. That's a killer. It was right there, and then he dropped it.
Oh, scumbag is killing me in the fantasy league.
Third down and eight. Talking about Butterfingers, he should have had that one. Most kickers should be able to make this one.
But will this kicker make it? Find out next time on MFL Game Day.
MFL isn't episodic. He's got the distance, and the kick is good. Yeah. home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. And it's first and 10. Second down and more than the QB would like. This guy's gonna get mugged in the locker room by his team after the game. Third down and, well, good luck. Oh, he just got crushed. Punter takes a break from knitting on the sidelines to come in and punt.
His knitting is superb, Grim. That cross-stitching, unbelievable.
They just let that one drop and played safe, and the defense says, we'll take it. It's first and 10. Defense holds him to a 4-yard pickup there. Second down and 6. Hit. And it's first and 10. Caught for the first down. First and 10. It's about a 3-yard pickup. Second down and 7. Third down, and the punter is warming up. And that's how you run the football. A pickup of 7 on the play.
Grim, why is it that more mentally disturbed clowns don't play football? They'd be good.
You know, they're all in politics, apparently. And he got it off. That's a decent punt. He's got the ball now, and he's going to try and score. Devastating hit. You ever get hit that hard, Bricks?
Yep. Third grade. Sister Mary Margaret of Our Ladies of Holy Hell. I thought it was brass knuckles, but it was just a regular knuckles.
Ooh, that hit's gonna shave a few days off his life. Second down and 6. Like he just saw 400 scary movies after that hit.
It sounds like my offseason.
Quarter 3 comes to an end, but this game is far from over and will be decided in the final quarter. And it's first and 10. for a yard. Second down and nine. He runs it for three. Third down and six. Man, this guy just blew up and he's on fire. I'm not talking about one of those video game fire modes. I mean, literally, he's like burning bacon down. He's rumbling and stumbling. He could go all the way.
I'm not saying the ref has been bribed, but he drove out of the field in a brand new hearse.
Third down and long. Offense says it's time to put the ref out of his misery. Third down and never gonna happen. You've got to catch that. You know, sometimes the best thing to do is just punt and let your defense get the ball back. Nice punt. Should move him back nicely. He's got the ball now. Let's see what he does with it. Oh, that was a big hit. Hey, Bricks, I bet you took a lot of shots like that over your career.
Let's see. About a quarter after three, Grim, but my watch is a bit slow.
That ball just sliced through the defense like butter.
I wish defenses were...
Nicely done for a first down. And it's first and ten. Okay, nice and easy, like a 2-foot putt.
You miss 2-foot putts all the time, Grim.
It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make them pay. First and ten. The defense has the receivers covered well. That's a 3-yard gain on that pass. Second down and seven. And this guy's running like an old guy looking for a bathroom. First down. And it's first and ten. Oh, man, he just laid the wood on that guy.
Yeah, if you're gonna hit a guy that hard, you should at least kill him. Do him a favor.
Finish him.
And it's first and ten. The quarterback just... Oh, the receiver has to make that catch. Now he put the team in a hole. Second down and ten.
Brix's mom decided to move back in with us.
Third and two. Oh, I love this dirty trick. Fee-fi-fo-fum. Stomp him into the ground, the dirty bum. Oh, I can't believe it ain't the whole thing. Drop, drop, fizz, fizz. Someone give that guy some Balka Schmelzer. First and ten. And let the work beat dirty trick. Look at him go!
If the Flash and the Roadrunner had a baby, and it was the fastest thing ever, this guy'd be faster.
Second down and ain't gonna happen, partner. Screw that up. No one died.
Bombs don't kill mutants, Grim. Mutants kill mutants.
Third down, and the QB is saying his prayers. And the punter takes a break from knitting on the sidelines to come in and punt.
His knitting is superb.
2 minutes left in the game. Hang on. Boring, but smart. Time to punt.
Whoa, whoa, you can't say that on the radio.
He boomed that one. Let's see if they can get a nice catch, and he turns on the afterburners. Punt returners in this league have a life. If there were any functioning brain cells before that hit, they're gone now. He's going to have the IQ of a rutabaga after that hit. And it's first and ten.
Hey, you see that move, baby? No, you didn't. You know why? I'm too fast for you. I'm the greatest. The greatest, I tell you.
Under 2 minutes, a timeout means the QB is playing beat the clock, and he better win. Second down, and we've got to pick up at least half of this. Oh, he almost broke that one wide open.
Hey, speaking of breaking one wide open, who's sitting on the oil rig?
The quarterback is controlling the clock right now like the clock is into it.
He just clock-blocked the clock.
Third down and, well, good luck. He caught it, and nothing was going to stop him from getting into the end zone.
Except maybe self-doubt, but he seems to have worked through it.
Yo, seriously, now you think you can go toe-to-toe with me? I will wreck your world. You understand me, Junior? I'll wreck your world.
Don't make any mistakes here, or they'll kick the shit out of you in the locker room. It's good. The teams are lined up for the kickoff. Looks like he'll be able to run this one back if he's not terrified for his life.
He is, but he's got no choice.
In a hurry-up offense, there is no huddle, so neither team can put their players on the bench. And the defense just called it, and he fumbles it, Brix. It was a screwed-up play if I ever saw one. And the quarterback goes into a hurry-up offense and calls all the plays from the line of scrimmage from here on out. And
next time. Call the timeout during halftime.
And the offense goes into a hurry up to pick up the pace of the game. That, my friends, was an all-pro MFL hit. First in, and they stopped the clock, but they only have one timeout left.
That's okay, Grim. They can have nine.
That's nice, Bricks. But our timeouts are for our sponsors, and we need money more than they do. Quarterback passes for a touchdown. And this guy has quite the female following. Listen to them.
Yeah, they all want to jump his bones.
I wish the middle linebacker would have jumped his bones. I just lost a sawbuck on that play.
I don't know which guy.
And here comes the extra point attempt. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
They need a good return here to set up the offense. Not a bad kick, but not a great one either.
Well, his nickname is Lukewarm.
And he's proud of that?
Yeah, that's why he named his clothing company.
Pow! And how about a little dirt sandwich? And the quarterback signals for a hurry-up offense.
Hey, Grim, what's the hurry-up offense?
There's no huddle. The offense calls plays at the line of scrimmage and plays really fast.
That's the way to keep the chains moving. That was beautiful.
Well, if you're into humiliation and scatological fetishes, this Burns loss was right up your alley.
Well, that's a waste of an afternoon if you're a Leaveland fan. But if you're from Leaveland, that's what everything feels like, I suppose. So, after you.
They fought tooth and nail, but in the end, lose by three. It's a hell of a thing losing at home.
They took away all they've got and all they're ever gonna have.
Yeah, well, they played like shit. Fuck 'em.
Fuck 'em indeed, Junior. Let's go down the field and see what that meathead has to say about his MVP award. With Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. and all the folks at Evil SN want to thank you for watching this presentation of the Mutant Football League.
Today's game was brought to you by the Hexon Oil Corporation. We drill it, spill it, and kill it so you...